So let me just go ahead and create a pond. Now, a couple of ways to do this. You can certainly right click on the object in Prospector like you're used to doing. But there are new objects up here in the Create Design panel for all of those types. So I can create a pond from scratch, just kind of picking points. Or I can draw something first and then turn that into a pond. And again, just to kind of tinker for 2 seconds for what's possible. So since we're sketching, it's giving me a dialogue. There's my name, some properties. How deep is it? What's my slope? What am I drawing? I'm drawing the top elevation. We'll say this is 105, etc. Hit OK. And now I'm going to start sketching the top of my pond. Oops, I don't want to go that far. So let's undo that last segment. And maybe something like that. And then we'll close it. Okay. So there's my pond. Actually, let me take a look at it over here in sort of 3D. And notice it actually is an object with a depth to it. Well, Kevin, there's hard edges. I'm never going to do a pond with hard edges. All right. That's just our first stab at it. What do we have? So we've got all these grips. There's a couple of different grips here to take a look at. So the center, or the centroid, if you will, that sort of slides the pond. The diamond helps us change the elevation of the offset values. And then, of course, I've got my boundary, which feels a lot like editing a polyline. So I've got choices there. So if I add a curve, I don't know, let's say 25 feet, you know, there's my 25-foot curve. So there's lots of choices there. What about on the midpoint? So same thing, stretch or add. So we'll just throw a few of these in here real quick, just for the sake of watching it do it over there, right? So you get the idea. Now taking a look, it almost feels like a grading object, right? If you're looking at it, sort of feels like it, right? But it's a pond. Okay. What am I trying to do? Add a curve. There we go. Nope. There we go. Okay, so that's a pond. And normally what happens is, I'm going to make a new network here. That's fine. And we'll use my structure with some pipe. My computer doesn't like this particular set of structures. There we go. So we'll pick a big pipe just so that we can see what's happening. And we'll draw the end of the pipe, actually outside of it for the sake of the moment. Because I want to try a couple of different things here, demonstrate. So what is the pond looking for? Is it looking for a structure to connect to? Notice as I move the structure around the pond, nothing is happening. But if I grab the end of the pipe, the pond is acting like a structure. So I guess I don't need that structure physically, just the end of the pipe. Not a flared end section, because a flared end section would still function as a, you know, another structure. So what does that do? So as we're, my elevations are clearly off, but that's okay. The idea is once you connect the pipe to the structure, in this case, the pond, just like with a structure, that pipe goes along with it. So whatever happens to that side, right, it's going along for the ride. Okay, so that's the pond object. Let's go back to the top over here. And we'll look at, oops, there's my profile. And let's look at where I'm gonna throw this pond in. I'm noticing the time, I'm trying to hurry along here a little bit. So let's do that again. I'll create a pond from scratch. Swale, really. How deep is it? I don't know. That sounds good. Top elevation. 3. I forgot the invert. Oh, there it is. 339. So, and that's down here. So yeah, that's about right. 339 at 6. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. So we'll say the top is 346. We'll go a little deeper and we'll do 1:1 since I've got sort of a narrow area here. Okay. So pick there, and then we'll close it. Throw in some curves. That's going to be too big. That's what I was worried about. Again, I'm kind of just doing this on the fly here. And one more. There we go. Again, I'm not attached. So let's make it attached. Right, something like that. So let's move this guy out of the way for the moment. In fact, oops. Yeah, let's make it do that. There we go. All right, so there is my profile. So this thing does not have a surface. So I mentioned it kind of feels like a grading object. There isn't a property to it. Oops. So like in a grading group, you can toggle on the surface. That's not the case here. But I do see my pond properties. I don't have an outfall pipe just yet, so there's nothing here. But you can see it is connecting. My inlet pipe is connected. And of course, there's my storage. So what can I do? So when you select the pond, there's also a contextual ribbon where I can get some feature lines from the pond and I can extract them and we'll do a dynamic link. That's fine. So now in that spot are feature lines. And if I add them to a surface as a break line, we'll call this I'll leave it the same name, swale. Man, if I could type. Not too concerned about the contours at the moment. I said, okay. We'll nut this down a little bit. There we go. And then there's the surface, at least for the inside of my pond. Okay. So that's sort of the intro to the pond. At this point, you would go back and rerun the analysis, right? So here I can pick the pond at this point, right? And start to include that in the process. But that's really what we're doing. I guess I didn't have really too much time to show the swale or the underground storage, but it all works the same way in the scheme of doing the drainage analysis. this analysis is going up to the cloud. Actually, let me cancel. One thing I forgot to mention, you're telling it where to calculate up here with this globe. And there are cloud services running in USA, Great Britain, and Australia to do this analysis. So this does have to be online. I missed that right out of the gate because I'd already had it set up. So when I'm hitting run, it knows where to go to do that. But other than that, everything else is the same. Again, this is a tech preview. This is version one, if you will. But the part that I love about it, especially if I just limit this to the pipe analysis, right? I could even have put a swale between structures, I suppose, if I had thought about that initially. Just that conveyance system and then getting it, analyzed and updated if I needed to, all without having to leave Civil 3D is probably the biggest point for me.